Muy buenas a todos, soy Mariachi. Bienvenidos a otro capítulo de este Kingdom Come Deliverance. Tenemos que ir a buscar distintas zonas donde supuestamente puede estar el amigo. Hediondo. Vamos a hablar con el padre lo primero, ya que estamos aquí. Tiro con arco. ¿Este qué nos dice? Yo creo que me tengo que bajar. ¡Oh! Tengo una resaca brutal.
Jesus Christ, be praised.
What's with the targets? Are you an archer by any chance?
I notice you're asking questions. Are you the Inquisition by any chance?
No, I'm Henry, of Scalis.
From Scalis? I'm Vata, from here. Why are you so curious about the targets?
It's just that I sometimes try my hand at archery too.
Try your hand, do you? I know plenty who do. When you can score as high as me at chumps, then I might be impressed.
I've got no idea what you're talking about.
Never played chumps? And you call yourself an archer? All right, Henry. Listen up. Chumps is a game for real archers. It tests your strength, stamina, and accuracy. And it can be a nice little earner. Unless you're, well, a chump.
So what exactly is it?
I'll tell you. A bunch of logs are floated down the river. Then you count to 20, and the archers run along the banks after the logs. At the end of the course, someone collects all the logs and counts the strikes. Whoever has the most, always meaning me, wins the bout. Each archer has 20 arrows with their own colored fletching, and the contest ends when the last log floats through the finish line.
Sounds like good fun.
Fun? My friend, it will bring you out in a proper sweat, and you'll be well pleased to hit just one or two blocks. So how about it then? Fancy a bout? You'll need your own bow, but I'll supply the arrows with colored fletching.
¿Qué? Vamos a probarlo, total.
Come on then. Ah, one more chump. Excellent. Now you have to bet at least 10 groschen, 50 at most. There'll be three archers competing at the time. The winner gets triple his wager and the second gets his coin back. So how much will you bet?
And why not?
30, venga.
That's the betting over with. Now here are your arrows.
Imagino que las tendré equipadas, a ver. Flechas tronco, sí. Perfecto, hala, vamos. ¿Dónde va el tío este? Malas trampas, ¿no? Que no me fío de ti, colega. Bueno, vamos a los troncos que están ahí. Aquí están todos. Bueno. ¿Le da uno ya? Dos. Vamos, tíos. Uy, el guaño 14 lleva. El de abajo lleva dos también. Hola. El agua, tío. Los dos primeros enganchados. Toma otra. Ahí va.
Another.
Bueno, eso no parece tan complicada, eso. Como aparecen dos juntos. ¿Qué me ha pasado? No me claves, no me claves. Nueve, vamos, vamos. Ahora que te lo clavo, tío. Diez, vamos. ¡11! ¡Vamos, sí! Llevo una ventaja de 5. Vaya, hombre. Matías, estoy aquí atrás. Vaya, me ha pasado. ¿Me han dado flechas? Las tengo que clavar, si no. Una más. 6, 6, 12. Probemos empatos. Si clavo, si engancho esta, gano. ¡Bingo! ¡Ja, ja! Robin Hood tiembla. Ha venido un arquero nuevo a la ciudad. ¿Qué? ¿Qué te ha parecido?
Well done, Henry. You've come first. It looks like you really do know what you're doing with a bow. You're still not up to my standard, mind you, but a pretty good effort. Here are your winnings. I hope you'll wager them on some chumps again.
Bueno, vamos a con el padre. Bastante más fácil que ir de caza, la verdad. Vamos a ver qué nos dice. Hablar con el padre, preguntar al compañero. Vamos a hablar con el padre, venga. Está ahí. Siempre igual podemos sacar algo de información. Uy. No ha sido buena idea esa de pasar por ahí en medio. Ese tiene pinta de que es el padre, ¿no?
Jesus Christ be praised. I'm looking for a fellow called Riki. Have you ever heard of him?
Shit. Why wouldn't I? That's what they call my son, Hinek.
Ah. You wouldn't happen to know where he is, would you?
I don't know nothing.
Don't you at least know where he usually goes? It's important.
Hinek shows up at home once in a blue moon, so I don't know nothing about where he gets to. Even if I did, why would I tell every Tom, Dick and Harry?
Your son is about to get into deep shit. I'm trying to find him so I can warn him.
That's nothing new. He's always up to his ears, innit?
But this time his neck's on the block. He got mixed up with some very dangerous people. I have to find him.
All right. He was here a few days ago, but he left right away. He looked like he was in a hurry.
And you don't know where he went?
I've got an idea, but I don't know where it is exactly.
I don't follow.
Hinek makes some money on the side from poaching. He boasted to me a few times about what a great hideout he found in the woods. But he never told me where it is.
Well, it's not much to go on, but it's better than nothing. Thank you. Don't you have any clue at all where his hideout could be?
I really don't know nothing about that. I could tell when he'd come from there, is all.
How's that?
Because every time he brought some hides for tanning and money.
What more do you know?
Nothing. I swear to God Almighty, I've said all I know. Hinnick never told me nothing.
I know he didn't talk to you about it, but you must have noticed something, right? How much time did he spend away? What was he wearing? How did he look when he came back? Anything?
Well, he came and went at all sorts of hours. I really don't know. Except maybe one thing. He'd come home scratched with brambles and with leaves and muck on him.
So he probably went through thick woods to get to that place.
I reckon. What do I know?
He had money because he sold the stuff right away.
I suppose. He never kept any of his loot here.
Do you know who he sold it to?
No. But the innkeeper came here now and again and gave him coin. Of course, it could have been for me.
All right. I'll ask at the inn then.
Ya no, el posadero, tío. Vale, vale. Vamos a ver dónde puede ser. Tienes un bosque frondoso. Buscar el pozo, ahí puede ser. Pues entra a la cueva. Vamos aquí a... Vamos a buscar ese, ya que estamos aquí cerquita. Creo que ya estoy. Sí. No. Aquí hay unas setas. En una cueva encontré una seta de cueva. Para hacer, no me acuerdo qué brebaje, pero no parece que aquí no hay. No, pues aquí no hay. Bueno, pues nada. Este bosque es bastante grande. No sé si podemos pasar el río, o sea, algún puente para poder pasar, si no me tengo que ir hasta el pueblo. Vaya. Vamos a ir a las orillas del río y a ver si encontramos algún sitio para poder cruzarlo. Algún sitio natural. No tiene pinta de que no. Porque el tío... no, nada, claro. Creo que me estoy dejando bastante... No, no tiene pinta. Habrá que ir a pueblo. Bueno, vamos a ir a pueblo. Despacio tú. No, esto es una presa. No, no tiene pinta de que se pueda. Venga, hasta el pueblo. Vea, subimos equitación que siempre viene bien. Igual lo suyo también es ir corriendo, ¿eh? Porque subimos vitalidad. Y yo creo que con la vitalidad mejora la capacidad de carga de nuestro personajillo. Tengo un poco de hambre, por lo que se ve. Bueno, son los leñadores. Ya que estamos aquí, yo creo que va a ser más fácil hablar primero con los leñadores. Preguntar a los leñadores.
I'd love to get something to eat. I'm starting to get hungry.
No tengo nada para comer, ¿no? Comida. No, no tengo nada para comer. A ver si puedo comprar algo. Hay pan y demás cosas. Vamos a comprar algo, pan. Más que nada porque si no va a empezar a meter ruido ahí. La tripa continuamente.
Why don't people like him?
The old Tanner's not an easy man, but a son should never let his father down. Hinnick does nothing to help. He's always far too busy with his own affairs, though I wouldn't like to say what those are.
And does no one at all talk to him?
That harlot Adela hangs around with him, of course.
Harlot?
She works as a bathhouse wench. Same thing.
Vale, eso ya está. Vamos a ver, vamos a comprar algo. Leche, pan. Bueno, algo ha subido. Vengamos a... Vamos a ver, carretera. Vamos a ir por aquí. A ver si podemos subir por algún lado. ¡Ah, qué bueno el caballo! ¡Qué lindo! Sí, están metidos en el bosque, macho. Campamento de leñadores. Me voy a ver si tengo aquí para comer algo, con un poco de suerte. Sí, vamos a comer un poco más. Que el pan estaba carísimo. Bueno, vamos a hablar con la peña.
I'm looking for Hinnek, the courier's son. I hear he sometimes comes here. Have you seen him?
Aye, he comes stinking round here sometimes. Ask Raspberry, he knows him.
Who's Raspberry?
You'll spot him easy enough. His face is red as a raspberry.
Bueno, hay muchos leñadores.
Good day to you.
I'm looking for Hinnek, the courier's son. I hear he sometimes comes here. Have you seen him?
Aye. He comes stinking round here sometimes. Ask Raspberry. He knows him.
Who's Raspberry?
You'll spot him easy enough. His face is red as a raspberry.
¿Dónde está Fresón? Mira, este tiene pinta que es, ¿no? Sí.
No, clear off. Let me sleep. Why are you waking me? Go away.
Venga, tío, levanta, no tengo todo el día.
Shit. Shut off. No, clear off. Let me sleep.
A ver, tenemos algo para tirarle.
Good day to you.
No. Ah, está que no. Va a esperar una hora a ver si se levanta el señor. Que son las 6, me da que igual no se levanta, ¿eh? Sí, se ha levantado, míralo, aquí está.
God be with you.
Your mates say you know Hinnek, the courier's son.
Reiki? Aye, he shows up here sometimes. Why do you ask?
I'm trying to find him.
Good luck, then.
What do you mean?
Reiki is like some bloody hedgehog, always creeping around in the woods. And just as prickly.
So you see him there often?
More like we don't see him.
Has he been here recently?
A few days ago. He came by in the evening, well into his cups. He might have fallen somewhere and broken his neck, for all I know.
So he went into the woods?
Aye, like always.
How do you know him?
We worked together building a mill by Yanovitz, and then he vanished. A year later, I came here to work, and lo and behold, there's Reiki.
Do you know what he gets up to in the woods?
What do you reckon? Making money. It's no secret he goes poaching.
You're speaking as if that's perfectly legal.
No. That's not allowed. I know. I mean, I think he might be poaching. But maybe he's gathering firewood. No way for me to know, right?
Firewood, of course. I hear Reiki has a hideout in the woods somewhere. Do you know where it is?
Aye. I think I was there once.
You think? What does that mean? Either you were there or you weren't.
Well, Once me and Hinnick had a bit of a drink together here, and we ran out of ale. Hinnick said he had some stashed away in the woods, so off we went.
But do you remember anything about it? The direction or which path you took?
Aye, I can tell you exactly. We went from the edge of the camp here along the path down to the creek. A little upstream, there's a fallen tree bridging the water. We went across it to the other side, then we went uphill to a big boulder. You have to listen carefully there.
Why?
There's a spring nearby. Someone put a kind of little mill wheel on the stream below it. You can hear it going clap, clap, clap all day and night.
Uh-huh.
Once you find it, you go around the spring and nearby you'll see a clearing. That's where Hinnick's hideout is. It's an old mine gallery or cave.
Muy bien. Sendero. Bueno, tiene pinta de... Tiene que ser esta. Por la descripción de Gadao, tenemos que bajar hasta el arroyo. Bajar por la corriente hasta ver un tronco caído. A ver, vamos. Mira ahí. Lo cruzamos. Vamos, tío. Tampoco hacía falta, creo yo, cruzarlo, pero bueno. Por encima. No es ahí. Ah, bueno, aquí hay un... Bueno, tiene pinta, ¿no?, de que puede ser por aquí. Ese pase del oso yogui.
Jesus Christ, what am I to do? Not that I can expect any useful advice from you. At least you have no more cares.
Need someone to talk to?
Fuck! Don't kill me. I can explain. I won't tell anyone. I swear, I've no one to tell anyway. Just please don't kill me.
I'm not planning to kill you.
You're not one of Runt's men?
No.
Huh. Then who are you?
Bueno, ya lo hemos encontrado.
I came to warn you. They're coming for you.
That's so. Good job, I'm hiding out here then.
They killed your friend, Lubos. Nailed him to the door of his own house.
Ah, why do you think I'm in hiding?
If you don't want to end up like him, you'd better tell me what you know.
And how will that help me?
If they come to a bad end, they won't be bothering you anymore, will they? And if you help me, I guarantee they will come to a bad end. One way or another.
Fine.
What do you want to know?
That Neuhof raid of yours didn't turn out quite as planned, did it?
Depends on whose plan you're talking about. We were up to it to grab some loot and bugger off, only Rudd's cutthroats was there to shed blood.
What do you mean, Rudd's cutthroats?
There were two gangs there, mine and Rudd's. We was only there to steal, but they wanted to slaughter everyone.
But when you realized what they had in mind, you didn't have to go along with it, did you?
But we didn't know nothing, even though we were going to Neuhof. They told us to keep watch on the courtyard while they were cutting the horses' throats. Jesus, that fucking vexed me. Their horses was the most valuable thing there. When I spoke up, though, Runt gave me such a bollocking, I knew I'd better keep my mouth shut. And when they said we was going to kill anything that moved, then we knew there was no going back.
That gang of yours, what can you tell me about them?
Don't know what you want to know. There was four of us. Me, Timmy, Limpy Lubosch, and Pious Pava. Sometimes we'd rob a place or hold up pilgrims. Never nothing fancy.
I'm sure you did mischief enough. Who led you?
Pious. He was the oldest, and he'd mostly find the jobs for us. Plan them and the like. He got us into that fucking mess in Neuhof, too.
What about the others?
Timmy's strong as an ox, with a brain to match. You got more sense out of a fence post. And Limpy, I've been with him the longest. He's my one and only friend, I suppose.
Who got your two gangs together? You must have made contact somehow, right?
Pius. He comes to us and says he's got this prime job. We're gonna rob a farm, he says. That was a big deal, because mostly we just did small stuff. I'll hold up on the road now and then. Nothing fancy. When they told us how much we could make on it, well, we just couldn't refuse.
So Pius knew them?
I suppose, but I don't know where from. We even got paid up front. I should have known from the start it was too good to be true.
Where did the rest of your gang end up?
You saw Limpy, right?
Yes, but he's no use to me now. Tell me where I can find Pius or Timmy.
I don't know nothing about Pius. He vanished in the woods, and I haven't seen him since. Timmy, I reckon, went back to the mill where he works.
Which mill?
The windmill a bit north of Neuhof.
Did you know any of Runt's people?
Not a one. They didn't talk to us at all. None of their faces was familiar either. The only thing I know is they called that huge chief of theirs Runt, and Pius warned us to watch out for him.
I don't suppose you know where they got to after the raid.
On the way to Neuhof, Timmy told me he was at their camp with Pius. I reckon that's where they've gone now.
Did Timmy tell you where the camp is?
Somewhere in the woods. He didn't say nothing more. Thing is, Timmy's got quite an imagination. But Pius roared at him to shut it, so I reckon there must be something in it.
Tell me exactly how the raid went down.
Well, we stormed in from the rear. Runt's people started slaughtering the horses. Jesus, that was bleeding horrible. Meanwhile, me and Limpy had a sniff round the stables to see if we could find anything worth pilfering. And in the end, we got lucky.
What did you find?
Smil, Sir Hanisher's groom. I don't know why he was up and what he was doing in the stables, but we took advantage of the situation. Limpy grabs him by the throat, and I slapped him round to encourage him to tell us where the money was. Then it all fell apart at the seams. Quicker than you'd believe, Runt comes running up and skewers the groom like a pig for roasting. My jaw dropped. I thought the stuff about killing was just tough talk.
And it wasn't?
No, not in the least.
What happened then?
I'm gaping at Smil, stuck through and through, and I noticed this boy standing at the other end of the stables. The stupid sods pointing at us, jaw hanging down to his knees, saying, I know you. Runt turns to us and hisses, take him down. So me and Lubosch start running, because the lad took to his heels. At the same time, we could hear the noise of the skirmish in the courtyard. We caught up with the boy at the next farmhouse. Knock him to the ground, but he bashes me with some piece of iron so hard my head's ringing like a fucking church bell. Limpy grabs it off him and stands over him with his bodkin in his hand, and I start praying.
In the end, Limpy just gives him a kick and says, "Beat it, Ginger." And then Runt shows up at the gate and hollers that we gotta go, so we scarp it.
What happened after the raid?
We were waiting for that fool, Timmy. Same place as we met them before, so he'd know where we were, right? Stupid fucking idea. But Pius didn't want to leave him behind. Only when Timmy finally turned up, two of Runt's men were dragging him.
There was some difference of opinion.
You could say that, yeah. They started on us right away that we were traitors. They knew we'd let somebody get away, and now we were going to pay for it. They started trying to surround us, and we knew what was coming. But Limpy took his bodkin and let that fucker have it in the belly.
Runt?
One of the others. Timmy broke free from them, and we all took to our heels. Luckily, they were so buggered from the raid, they didn't follow us for long. They just shouted that they'd find us.
Me lío. No quería darle eso. Vamos a irlo otra vez. Bueno, voy a estar. Corta el pescuezo. Vaya.
People, we've got to get out of here.
They're too close. We'll never outrun them.
Fuck.
At least they don't know I'm here. The two of us can take them by surprise.
No fucking way. I'm gone.
Look here. If you run, they'll catch up with you and kill you. And me too. Together, we stand a better chance.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All right. I suppose you're right.
Qué emocionante se pone. Bueno, pues vamos a dejarlo aquí. Partida guardada. Yo creo que es un buen momento para acabar el capítulo. Seguiremos justo aquí en la batalla contra esto. Ya sabéis, un buen like, un buen comentario, alguna suscripción. Sed buenos. Nos vemos.